One thing that I've really found to be powerful in my journey, in my life, has been understanding that God is not coming to save me. He already did that. Jesus came, died, paid the price. He's in heaven right now, interceding for me. He sent his Holy Spirit to help me through life. What more do I want? Right? So understanding the power that dwells within me just by being myself. Right? I am God's masterpiece. So he has given me everything that I need for life and godliness. Everything that I need. So who am I waiting for? Why do we live these average, mediocre lives? You are co-creator. Co-creator with God. Right? God made the whole universe. He didn't make tables. He didn't make chairs. He didn't make airplanes. He just made the earth and its natural stuff. And then he put humans in there. No other animal is able to do what humans can do with their minds. We're able to make paper from trees. We're able to build homes, and therefore we don't relocate because of weather. We're able to settle down and be creative and change our environment. That's who we are. You might not be seeing you being creative and solving issues in your life, but that just indicates that there is potential in you. And potential is something that we might exalt, say, yeah, I have potential. But that potential has the capacity to die as potential. You can live 100 years and your potential remain untampered with. And that's just a sad way to live. Why? Because we are afraid. Why? Because we don't know, we don't understand. And so we just think, oh, just live the way we're living. No, no. You are co-creator. You have power to make a change. You are amazing. You are a powerful being. When will you know that and take charge of your life? You must take charge of your life. You must live to see your dreams manifest into something. What is your contribution? We fly in airplanes right now. We write on paper. I'm on camera right now. That's somebody who contributed something from their minds to the ground. What is your contribution? What can you do? You can't just come and consume and die. You can't just come and fit in and die. That's not it. Can't be it. But unless you do the work, you will not experience the rewards of this work. It saddens me to think that I don't know my great-grandfather or my great-grandmother. I don't know those people because I don't know what they did with their lives. It doesn't affect me directly. I'm grateful for the genetics they gave me, but that's about it. You and I can be easily forgotten too. But we remember people like David Livingstone. We remember even Jesus. We remember like Mary Magdalene. We remember so many other people who lived way back, but not even your great-grandfather or great-grandmother. Why? Because they didn't do anything with what God put in them. No offense to your great-grandparents and to mine, but just being real here, don't be forgettable like that. God didn't make you to just come and fill a space and pass on some genes and go. He had a plan, a mark that only you can make. That's why he said in his word that before you were formed, I knew you. That means before he put you in this earth, he thought through it and thought the world needs this person to make this specific impact. Make that impact. Make it. All right? So there'll be opinions. People have opinions. People have mindsets. People have things to say about what you're doing, what you're not doing. But you and God should be on the same page. You should understand your power. You should not sacrifice anything for people who didn't die and pay a price for you. You should not live to get their approval. People who don't even know the full story of your life. People who don't know what you do before you sleep, when you're breaking down or you're feeling unfulfilled. They don't know that. So shut it down. Don't care about people's opinions. Just you and God. What's going on there? Where are you going with your life? Do it. Do something. Start something. Be bored. Make mistakes. Get up after mistakes and try again. Live a meaningful life so that your great-grandchildren are going to be like, there was a guy, there was a girl, my great somebody who did something amazing and is firing us up to now. The poverty that we're experiencing right now, our great-grandparents didn't do anything about it. They set us up for poverty. Right? So there are some people who are born, they'll never know poverty. Them and their children will never know poverty. And you might say, well, that's just something, it's worldly. But the Bible even says that a good man leaves an inheritance for his grandchildren.
not for his children, not just that one house for that one child. He leaves an inheritance for his great-grandchildren so that they are blessed when they are being born. Right? Like the blessing of Abraham, Abraham's obedience changed the whole trajectory of the people who came after him. Abraham. And here we are tugging into the blessing of Abraham even today. One man's obedience, one man stepping up. When God told him, you don't know where I'm calling you to, but move. He moved. What is God telling you today? To move to what? Are you moving? Are you scared? Right? So who is being cursed in the generations to come because you're failing to move, because you're comfortable with just getting what you're getting and just looking down and say, I don't want to be judged, I don't want anything. Come on, generations need us to arise and do something. Do something, all right? You have a purpose, you have a plan, God has it for you. Step up, start something, be there, be present, make your life count. This doesn't mean you should do what anything just to make a mark. It means you should do what God has set aside for you. So take time to think about you. What are you good at? Where are you going? What is that desire you can't shake off? Embrace that. Be bold with that. Let's move. Let's move.